Again, again, again. Are you going to work?
Of course.
Oh, I thought that...
What?
Well, I was hoping we could go have a picnic in Piedmont Park this afternoon.
What?
Did you forget? Today is Confederate Memorial Day.
Oh, Confederate Memorial Day is asinine. Why would anyone want to celebrate losing a war?
Heavens, Leo. If Georgia is so asinine, why did you move here in the first place?
You know why. Because your uncle offered me a good job. I should have realized that it pays so well because, well, you have to live in Atlanta to do it.
I guess that's what I get for marrying a Yankee.
You dropped a pin.
Minnie will get it when she picks up. I was just sure today would be a day off.
Not for the superintendent.
A superintendent? Honestly, the way you slave yourself down there, a person would think you own that old pencil factory.
Oy, don't be such a mashugana.
Why do you use words like that?
Because they're Jewish words, and I'm Jewish.
Well, I am too, but that doesn't mean I have to speak a foreign language.
For the life of me, I can't understand how God created you people Jewish and Southern at the same time.
Well, Confederate Memorial Day is a holiday in this part of the world, whether you like it or not. May I plan a picnic for the 4th of July? Will you be working then, too?
Lucille, we've been through all this. I work hard because I'm trying to build us up enough of a nest egg so that we can... Well, you know what I mean.
Procreate? It's not a dirty word, Leo. It's written all over the Bible. So we can... procreate!
I'll be home in time for supper.
Are you blushing? I swear I think you are.
You dropped another pin.
Evermore this dream of the tongue. Evermore her eternal pride. Strong shore this dream of the tongue. When her brothers are unified. And the sound of her voice is clearer. When the people are proud and free.
And therefore, I am especially proud to serve as your governor today. For today, we honor those who honored us, fighting the war some 50 years ago. Those who gave unimaginable sacrifices and suffered unimaginable degradation, but never defeat. The men of Georgia and the women of Georgia have never been defeated!
I go to bed at night, hoping when I wake, this will all be gone like it was just a dream. And I'll be home again, back again in Brooklyn. Back with people who look like I do, and talk like I do, and think like I do. But then, the sun rises in Atlanta again. These people make me tense. I live in fear they'll start a conversation. These people make no sense. They talk and I just stare and shut my mouth. It's like a foreign land. I didn't understand that being Southern's not just being in the South. When I look out on all this, how can I call this These men belong in zoos. It's like they never joined civilization. The Jews are not like Jews. I thought the Jews were Jews, but I was wrong. I thought I would be fine. But 4 years down the line, with every word, it's very clear I don't belong. I don't cuss, I don't drawl, so how can I call this home? Home calls, and I'm free of the southern breeze. Free of magnolia trees and endless sunshine.
Atlanta,
but not mine, not mine. A Yankee with a college education, his own design, is trapped inside the land the time forgot.
Strong and proud.
Trapped inside this life, and trapped beside a wife who would prefer that I'd say howdy, not shalom. Well, I'm sorry, Lucy. What I feel, and this place is surreal. So how can I call this home?
Hey, sunshine.
Sunshine? Looks like rain to me.
Well, not from here, it don't.
Freaky ass, you quit that right now, you hear?
What? I ain't doing anything. You wanna go to the picture show? There's a movie I've got to see. You know the one called The Silver Gun? Well, I've been watching since chapter 3. I can't wait, it's at 8, and I was wondering if you're free.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. You know my mama never let me till I turned 16. Go on, go on, go on, go on. Said to only go to pictures that I haven't seen.
Well, when do you turn 16?
2 years from next June.
Too bad about your mama.
Too bad for you.
I know a spot in your McConic slot where you can see the parade real clear. I got a book you wanna take a look. It's called The Thief and the Brigadier. I got gum, you want some?
I haven't chewed gum for a year.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. I bet your mama let me take you to the picture show.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. I guess you weren't really listening when I said no. When I asked Iola Stover, her mama lets her do whatever she wants.
I was hoping I could go with you. I will.
I hope you do.
Wait, where are you going?
To the factory. I didn't get my pay this week.
Okay, see you around.
At the picture show?
What? I thought your mama wouldn't let you.
She will with Essie and Betty Jean, just not with you.
Bye, sunshine. Dee 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 dee. Go on, go on, go on, go on. Why, Iola, you going to the pictures tonight?
Everyone lives the dream of Atlanta. Everyone her eternal pride. Strong and sure lives the dream of Atlanta. When her brothers are
unified. 28 boxes of caps at $4 the gross. This is wrong, this is wrong, I can fix this, wait. 9 more boxes and back, 28 minus 9. And then 31 girls on the line.
Suit and a tie.
Times 6, 186.
The quiet.
Divide 760.
Quite a well-paid position.
Got all the noise and on Yontif yet.
Go on, Lucy.
4 cents a girl for the
bring
week.
Bring him his coffee.
And 10 cents an hour.
Straight from New York, Lucy. Isn't he smart, Lucy? Mama, he's coming around today. Mama is at the door. Mama, I don't know what I should say. Well, what are you waiting for, Lucille? What am I waiting for?
This is wrong, this is wrong. It's an 8, not a 6.
A house and a maid, 2 sets of china. Everything I was wishing. New winter coat, a real ermine collar. Who would have known, Lucy? Married so well, Lucy. How can he want me so plain, so prim? How can he be so sure? Don't I wish I could be sure like him, like Leo?
Yes, Lucille, I am building a life for us.
For Leo.
No, Lucille, we cannot have a picnic.
Oh, didn't my wishes come true?
This is wrong, I can fix this.
Hey!
Yes?
I came for my pay.
Name?
Mary Fagan.
I don't see it here. Employee number?
507.
Ah, not Fagan as in Dickens. Fagan as in phalanx. 12 hours, 10 cents an hour, $1.20. Here you are.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Frank.
What is it?
This the residence of a Leo M. Frank.
Yes, sir.
Something the matter?
Is Mr. Frank at home, ma'am?
Yes.
Can we speak to him, please?
Leo?
Leo M. Frank?
Yes. What's happened?
We're gonna need you to get your shoes on and come with us.
Oh, God. Has something happened at the factory?
Just get your shoes on, please.
I will. Oh, God. I need to have my coffee. I'll be with you, gentlemen, in just a moment, just as soon as I have my coffee. Has there been a fire? Tell me. Just tell me it's a fire, isn't it?
Leo, gentlemen, the coffee's almost ready.
A tragedy has occurred. We do not have time for coffee.
A tragedy? What, is somebody dead? Is somebody dead? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
You know who this is, Mr. Frank?
Oh, God, it's the little girl I paid yesterday. She came up to my office.
Can you give us her name, please, sir?
I can't think. Oh, God. Farrell? No. Oh, Faley? Fagan. The name is Fagan. P-H-A-G-A-N.
Fagan.
Yes. I'm seeing no
Is this going to be in the newspapers?
Does that bother you, sir?
Well, of course it bothers me. How does it look for the company to have a child killed in the basement?
Was she killed in the basement, Mr. Frank?
Well, I would assume so. Who did it? Do you know who did it yet?
This old white money, but the town sticking out this pretty little child to my
oh, no, you don't. You don't think it was my night watchman, Newt? Newt Lee? Do you think it was Newt?
So I ran to the phone and I called Mr. Frank, but the phone kept ringing, so I called y'all to help me. Mr. Frank, he didn't answer, and that's all I can remember.
Oh, God. Oh, my God, you think that... Well, that's ridiculous. It's absurd. I was at home all night. I didn't even know this girl. Well, she only came up to my office yesterday because I paid her. How could you possibly? Look, there are no marks on me. Where are the scratches? Where are the bruises? I want you to write that down. What do you see?
Mr. Frank.
Nothing. Write that down.
Put your clothes on.
Can I go home and have my breakfast?
No, sir. I'm afraid you can't do that.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm hoping you can help me.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, my daughter, she didn't come home last night.
Can I have your name, please, ma'am?
Careful that gun.
Oh, well, if it ain't the star reporter, what the hell are you doing, Craig?
covering the police beat.
That's so? Well, then you better move your sorry ass. Looks like District Attorney's about to make a statement. You might have yourself a story.
Thanks, friend. I'm on it. I'm on it!
It is my sad duty to report the murder of a 13-year-old child has taken place. Chief of Police Starnes has informed me that he is holding two men for questioning. They are Ludie Newton Lee, Negro, employed as night watchman at the National Pencil Company, where the murder took place, and Leo Max Frankel, Caucasian, formerly of Brooklyn, New York, superintendent of same. Make that Frank, not Frankel. Now, rest assured, the killer of this little May Fagan will not roam free. Thank you, gentlemen. I'm on my way to church to pray for her soul right now. I imagine everybody in Atlanta wants to do the same thing.
What is this?
Your dinner.
You expect me to eat this?
Uh-huh.
I have had nothing on my stomach since last night, not even coffee. For your information, I am under a physician, and I do not eat grease. That is all grease. Take it away. Bring me an apple and some coffee.
Uh-huh. I got some company for you, Leo.
Leo.
What?
How are you?
How do you think?
I wish you wouldn't act so ugly to the guard.
It's ridiculous.
He's only doing his job, honey.
Fine. Doesn't matter. I'll be out of here by tonight.
Well, I brought you some clean clothes just in case.
I won't be needing them.
Well, better safe than sorry.
Safe? You think I'm safe? Are you out of your mind? Do you have eyes in your head? Look at me, Lucille. I've never committed an illegal act in my whole life, and here I am, locked up in a jail cell. Do you see where they expect me to go to the toilet? Did you see that plate of pig fat and cornbread they expect me to eat? Do you have any idea what spending the night here would be like?
I just wanted you to be comfortable.
Well, I'm not. I'm not comfortable, and I'm not safe, and I'm mighty sorry.
Leo!
Go on home, Lucille. Guard! I'll be home in time for supper. Let my wife out. God.
Fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains. The dying thief rejoiced.
A simple white pine coffin was carried by two of Mary's cousins and two of her young friends. Several other friends offered to serve as pallbearers, but were deemed too small to shoulder the burden. Light as it was, as Mary Fagan, 2 months shy of 14.
God, forgive me what I think. God, forgive me what I wish right now.
You must have known Mary pretty well.
Yes, sir, I did.
Well, this must be a mighty hard day for you.
Did you ever hear her laugh? When she laughed, you swore you'd never cry again. Did you ever see her smile? Her smile was like a glass of lemonade. And she said funny things, and she wore pretty dresses, and she liked to see the pictures at the VFW hall. And she loved riding swings. She loved cotton candy. But I think she liked the pictures best of all. No, it don't make sense. sense to me that she won't be around. No, it don't make sense to me to put her in the cold and lonely ground. And no, it don't make sense the way forgive me what I wish right now. I don't know the coward's name. I don't know the bastard's face. But I swear right now to God, he ain't never gonna get away with what he done to Mary. Let him quiver in his boots. Let him run till he bleeds. I won't rest until I know he's burning in the raging fires of hell
its door. Sleep, sleep, little angel, never you fear, I will be here, keeping you safe and pure.
I swear, Miss Sally, being First Lady, agrees with you. And now you can pass for 18 years old.
No, you don't, see. Sincere as ever.
Oh, yes, ma'am, I surely am.
You never change, do you?
Not if I can help it.
You sweet-talking my wife again, Dorsey.
Absolutely.
Will you gentlemen excuse me?
Ugly business, Huey. Murder of a little girl.
Sure is, Jack. I mean, Governor Slayton.
You know who they're gonna blame, don't you?
Well, certainly not you, Governor.
Damn right, me. And you. And everybody else holding public office. You better get to the bottom of this one fast.
Well, we are holding two suspects over yonder at Fulton Tower.
Good. convict one of them?
I'll get you what you want. Y'all have a nice day now.
Jack.
Sleep, sleep, little angel. Fear not the sound of drums. Never you cry. Justice is nigh. Soon Armageddon comes.
Well, how you doing this morning, Newt?
All right, thank you, sir.
Hey, did they get you a coffee yet? Well, hell's bells, have mine. Now, you had something you wanted to say to me, didn't you, Newt? Well, it was all an accident, wasn't it? Well, I mean, it was really her fault. I mean, she looked right at you, and she smiled. And you were standing so close, and she was smelling so sweet. Oh, but you are a man, Newt. After all, a red-blooded man. And so am I. And so is Ivy. And we know what it feels like to be up next to a sweet-smelling girl. Near enough, you can feel that hot breath on your face.
I'm the resurrection alive.
I've been there, Newt. It's part of being a man. I know. You had to touch her. You had to smell that skin, huh? You could tell how much she wanted it. You can tell me, Newt. You helped her slide down her drawers. Oh, let him go. Hanging another nigger ain't enough this time. We gotta do better. I said get him out of here! It was Leo Frank murdered that little girl.
Are you sure about that?
Jesus Christ on a stick, of course I'm sure! It's in his hands. See how he rubs them both together like he's trying to get them clean. It's in his eyes. Wonder why he stares at the floor and won't look you straight in the face. Something ain't right. Oh, I can tell something ain't right. I can see it in his eyes, boy.
We got no evidence.
You want evidence? Look at those clothes and that big fancy talk. Huh? You want evidence? Look how he's sweating from every pore. Can't you see him just standing there watching that little girl bleed? He smells of it. He stinks of it. What more do you need?
An eyewitness wouldn't be bad.
That's right. So get the hell out of here and go find one! News, my savior has arrived. My intuition's never been so strong. Big news, my career has been revived. All I needed was a snippy, pissy Yankee all along. Take a superstitious city, add one little Jew from Brooklyn, plus a college education and a mousy little wife. And big news, real big news, that poor sucker saved my life. Give him fangs, give him horns, give him scaly hairy palms, have him drooling out the corner of his mouth. He's a master of disguise, check those bug out creepy eyes, sure that fella's here to raid the whole damn South. They'll be banging down my door, yelling, more Craig, more, call for justice, we need justice, hang the bastard, beat the bum. Big news, real big news, my savior has finally come.
Your lawyer's here, Leo.
Mr. Rosser, did you arrange it? Am I going home now?
No, Leo, you're not.
Why not? Are you doing your very best to get me out?
Leo.
Have you thought of everything? Are you absolutely
Leo,
sure?
Do you want to find another lawyer, my friend? You go right ahead.
No, I just want this ridiculous nightmare to be over.
Of course. Have you seen the papers?
Of course I haven't seen the papers. I'm in jail, remember?
I'm afraid you have a lot to answer for. You can't lie to me if we're gonna get anywhere, Leo.
I never told you a lie.
Well, are you familiar with the James Gant?
He was my bookkeeper.
Well, he says he saw you come out of your office at 12 noon, Memorial Day. You're sweating like a pig, your shirt tail all hanging out.
Gant hates me because I was about to fire him and he knew it. He'd say anything to get back at me.
Okay, what about Lena Fox, age 17?
Who?
Senior at Girls High. Says you came up to her in Piedmont Park on Easter Sunday and asked her out for a drink.
I was at home all day and I can prove it.
What about Miss Nina Formby?
No.
She runs a cat house in there in Decatur Street. She says you're a regular customer.
That's a lie.
She says you like them young. You like them right off the farm.
Why would she say that? I don't even know this woman.
She said one time you asked her if she could introduce you to some young boys.
That is vile. Never in my life
have I... Did you do that?
How dare you ask me that? I won't even dignify such a question with an answer.
You need to get off your high horse and do it right now. Word came down this morning. You've been indicted for the murder of Mary Fagan.
Indicted? Does that mean there's going to be a trial?
Oh, yeah. And if I know Hugh Dorsey's gonna run a regular showboat in that courtroom, he's famous for it, so let's be prepared.
I am innocent.
Dorsey's got nothing but circumstantial evidence, no matter how big a show he puts on, all right? You're gonna walk out of there a free man.
Am I?
Count on it.
According to reports obtained exclusively by this reporter, Prosecutor Dorsey has the villain in his sights. A highly ranking unnamed source in this investigation tells me Leo Frank's the only likely culprit in this case. Anyone with any information on the suspect Leo Frank should contact this reporter, care of the Atlanta Jordan.
I saw this little kid, said look what Leo did, and then she run in here.
Go on now.
He said no.
Go on now.
I say it isn't fair.
Some young and tall, got naked pictures
that
on.
A millionaire.
Pictures of his
wife. Go on now.
He has a kid.
Just scribble it down and it covers the town like molasses or mud. Look, for us drunken old bums, opportunity comes in a magical flood. Look, you might never be sure if your motives are pure, but your profits are clear. Look, you were down and depressed, now you're riding the crest of the scoop of the year.
Now, Jim, says your job at the factory is sweeper, that right?
I prefer cleaning supervisor if you don't mind.
Cleaning supervisor, then. Can you tell me anything else interesting about Mr. Frank?
Well, he does himself like this all the time.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Anything else?
Well, now let me think.
Did he ever bring any of them factory girls up to his office?
Girls?
You know, Jim, I got a piece of paper here. Says you spent a little time on the chain gang.
Is that right?
Twice, according to this, drunk and disorderly behavior.
Well, I tend to over-celebrate holidays.
Mm-hmm. And the second time here says you're out with the road gang. You just up and disappeared.
Well, you know, my time was just about up.
Really? No, I think you had a few more months left. Now, you know what that makes you, don't you?
Okay.
I was gonna say an escaped convict. Now, what are we gonna do about that?
What was that you said about Mr. Frank?
Please! Let me alone!
Let's leave this lady alone! Come on. I hope there's not too much damage, ma'am. Oh, no, 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 no. I just came out of help.
I have nothing to say.
Watermelon pickles? Well, that's one of my mama's specialties, and deviled eggs. Why, you're a good cook.
Not really?
Oh, yes. Well, this nose knows all. I can only imagine how difficult this must be for you, Miss Frank. All those stories coming out about your husband every day.
You don't know this man. You don't know a thing. You come here with these horrifying stories, these contemptible conceits, and you say you understand how a man's heart beats. But you don't know a thing. You don't know this man. You don't even try. When a man writes his mother every Sunday, pays his bills before they're due, works so hard to feed his family, there's your murderer for you, and you stand there spitting words that you know aren't true, then you don't know this man. I don't think you could. You don't have the right to know. Anyone who knows him, not a morsel, not a crumb, not a clue.
You're saying he's honest. You're saying he's decent. But ma'am, you're not saying he's innocent.
I have nothing more to say to you.
Did you pay the bill for Jacob's drugstore this month?
It just came yesterday.
We don't want people thinking we can't pay our bills.
I'll tend to it this evening.
I don't know why they won't let me have my checkbook.
It must be against the law.
Ridiculous. What kind of sense does that make?
I told you. I'll tend to the bill this evening.
Don't forget.
I put a jar of watermelon pickles in with your dinner.
Oh, and did the life insurance bill come? It should have by now.
No, not yet.
Well, pay it the second it comes. I'm sure they're just looking for a reason to drop it.
Leo, I'm thinking of going to visit Aunt Miriam in Savannah.
I see. When?
I'm not sure. A week or two?
Well, just be back when the trial starts.
That's where I'm going, Leo.
What?
The trial. I don't think I can stand it.
Well, you have to stand it. How would it look if you run out of town?
I don't want all those people staring at me when they say those awful things about you in the courtroom.
Ridiculous. They won't be staring at you. They'd be staring at me anyway. It's all just a bunch of lies and nonsense.
The mother of that poor little girl. I don't want to see her.
I don't like the way you're talking.
Well, I'm just telling you how I feel, Leo.
You have to be there.
I'll be here tomorrow with your dinner.
Lucille.
What is it?
You have to be there.
Stop the rising river. Who will stop the lies from being told? Who will fight for the people of Georgia? Who's gonna swing the hammer of justice? Who's gonna be the last one standing? Who'll keep the past from getting sold? Who will stand with the people of Georgia? Who's gonna swing the hammer of justice? My children want to know. My children have been crying for a savior who rides within this land. My people want to know. They ask me, where's the man to take a stand and raise his hand? devil? Who's gonna cut the puppet string? Who'll restore this angel's honor? Who's gonna swing,
gonna swing that hammer?
The hammer of justice.
Oh, morning, Leo. You look fine.
Am I?
But Dorsey has nothing but circumstantial evidence, all right? Buck up. What's your better half?
I wish I knew.
Who's gonna stop our borders leaking? Who's gonna keep the refuse out? Who's gonna soothe our baby shrieking? Who's gonna swing that hammer? Who's gonna fight the vile villain? Who's gonna defy the bravest doubt? Who's gonna stop the Jew from killing? Who's gonna swing that hammer?
All rise! Upon the Lord to bless these court's proceedings, bless all those who are involved, and keep us in your ways. Amen.
Amen.
Well, get on with it, Dorsey.
Your Honor, gentlemen of the jury, and good people of Georgia, there is a farmhouse in Marietta, kind of battered and forlorn. And in that farmhouse, 14 years ago, a girl named Mary was born. And she would dance in fields of cotton. She had a tree where she could play. But when her daddy died 2 years ago, Mary and her mama moved away. It's only 20 miles from Marietta to a factory in the center of this town. And 20 miles was all it took to strike that sweet girl down. People of Atlanta fought for freedom to their graves, and now their city is a factory and their children are its slaves. People of Atlanta swing their city gates wide and look at what you've wrought. So, Frankie, you said you rode downtown with Mary on the English Avenue streetcar.
Yes, sir. Morning of the Memorial Day parade.
And can you tell us what happened?
Well, she wanted to go to the picture show real bad, so I promised I'd take her after the parade. But first she had to stop to the factory to get her pay.
And did she get off?
No, sir. Not right then.
Well, Frankie, tell us what happened.
She got up to go, and she looked funny. And I said, something wrong, Mary?
Mr. Frank,
what?
Looks at me.
Looks at you? Everybody looks at you.
Not like Mr. Frank.
What does he do? See, I come over there and break his face.
Go on. You'll miss the picture show. I'll see you over at the parade.
Well, let's let me go to the factory with you to get your pay.
Save me a seat.
That was the last time I ever saw her. I wish I had come over there and broke your damn face!
Who's gonna stop the blood from spilling?
Your witness.
Who's gonna save the people of Georgia? Who's gonna swing the hammer of justice?
Aula Stover, would you please describe for the court Mr. Leo Frank's manner in the factory?
You call my name, I'll turn my
don't you come up to my office? Got a couple of things you might like to see. Why don't you come up to my office about 2:15 till a quarter to three? If you can maybe swing by, honey, will you know that be okay with me? If you came to my office. Why don't you come up to my office? Got a bottle of wine and the cork ain't popped. Why don't you come up to my office where it's nice and cool when the blinds are dried? Just take a break and swing by. Honey, we pretend that old clock is stopped. If you came to my office. I know this new dance that they're doing in Manhattan. I'll get you dancing like you never done before. And I'll bring you things that they sent me from Manhattan. And if you like, hell, I got more. Hell, I got more. Why don't you come up to my office? Got a fine fried chicken and biscuits for two. Come on and come up to my office. Got lots of things that we both can do. Just take a break and swing by. Honey, no one asked to know but me and you. If you came. So come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come out and come up to my.
He got no word to say. His eyes get big, my face gets red. I want to run away. And he looks, and I wait, and he smiles.
Somebody told him to say all that. They were coached.
Children speak the truth. The children call for vengeance of the innocence we never can replace.
My name is Manola McKnight.
The children speak the truth. The sodomite is laughing in your face.
I've been working for Miss Lucille and her husband since they married 3 years last November.
Good. Now, Minnie, will you work on April 26th, Memorial Day?
Yes, sir.
And can you tell us what transpired happened that day?
Mr. Frank, he come home for his dinner at 1. He come running in and he look funny.
Funny in what way?
His eyes popping out and his face turning red. And he jump up and leave for I put his dessert on the table. Coconut cake too, his favorite.
That's not true,
man. Water in the cold room.
Can you tell me anything else peculiar about that day?
Objection, this leaving the witness. Objection sustained.
Anything else out of the ordinary occur?
Morning, I see Miss Lucille. She look like she ain't had a minute of rest. She says Mr. Frank made her sleep on the floor and that she ain't allowed in the bed anymore.
That isn't how it happened. Shame on Minnie.
Thank you, Minnie. That'll be all. Miss Fagan, could you please describe for the court, ma'am, the outfit your daughter was wearing to town last Memorial Day?
Yes, sir, I can. It was her Easter Sunday outfit, a little lavender cotton pongee dress I made her, white stockings, and her party shoes.
And would these be those clothes?
Mm-hmm.
for taking her out of the school. My child will forgive me for not doing more to protect her from men who are cruel. My child will forgive me for closing my eyes to the dangers of growing too fast. My child will forgive me with tears in her eyes when we're reunited at last. My child will be safe in the arms of the Lord and as pure as the day of her birth. My child will be cozied and blessed and adored as she never could be here on earth. My child will be watching me, giving me faith in a future that's golden and new. My Mary will teach me to open my heart, and so I forgive you. Jew!
I call Jim Conlin. Objection! Objection!
Mr. Dorsey! Would you instruct your witness to answer only the questions put to him?
Jim, do you understand the man?
Yes, sir.
All right, then. All right, Jim. Can you tell us about the morning of April 26th?
The day of the parade?
Uh-huh.
He told you to lock the door, watch the door.
No!
you are well aware, the law in the state of Georgia does not allow a defendant to testify in a murder trial. However, said defendant is allowed to make a statement. Does your client wish to make a statement at this time?
He does not, Your Honor.
Yes, sir. I do.
Leo!
It's hard to speak my heart. I'm not a man who bears his soul. I let the moment pass me by. I stay where I am in control. I hide behind my work, safe and sure of what to say. I know I must seem hard. I know I must seem cold. I never touched that girl. You think I'd hurt a child yet? I've barely seen her face before. I swore we'd barely met. These people try to scare you with things I'd never said. I know it makes no sense. I'm sure I don't know why you see me as I am. You can't believe I'd lie. You can't believe I'd do these deeds. A little man who's scared and blind, too lost to find the words he needs. I never touched that child, God. I never raised my hand. I stand before you now incredibly afraid. I pray you understand.
This angel met her end on the concrete floor of a sweatshop where she toiled away her childhood, fastening erasers to pencils for 10 pennies an hour. She died a noble death without a splotch or blemish upon her. Your Honor, I have done my duty. I have no apologies to make. And there will be but one verdict. Guilty! Guilty! Guilty.
Gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
What say you?
Guilty.
Guilty. Guilty.
Guilty.
Guilty. Guilty.
It is hereby adjourned and ordered that on the 28th day of May, in the year of our Lord, 1914,
guilty.
That Leo Max Frank shall be hanged by the neck until he is dead. And may God have mercy on his soul.
Not much.
Well, I'm black and blue from all your thrashing around.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
It's this Frank thing, isn't it?
Seems like everybody in the world wants to stick their nose in our business.
Mm. Well, maybe I better go sleep in the guest room for a while.
Well, I wouldn't want you to do that, Miss Sally.
We're rumbling and rolling. It's coming down from the north. It's coming up through the ground, and it's a funny old sound. Cause it's a rumbling and a rolling. Attention. Sure they're gonna ask why.
They gonna say, I don't know what, I don't know how. Well, they are gonna find out now. They're gonna pay attention.
They're gonna yell, set that man free. Well, they sure ain't talking about me.
Tell me something I don't know.
Now there's a rumbling and a rolling. Here come the Yankee Brigade.
They gonna come through this town. We better keep our heads down.
We better start mumbling and a shuffling.
We better polish our smiles.
Old Black Joe at your service. Won't do nothing that'll make you nervous. Won't do nothing worth a look or a mention.
And they won't never pay attention.
They're gonna say, bring me my boots,
bring me my tea.
I bet you thought the slaves were free.
Mr. Frank, good for you. A lot of folk coming to get you through. Mr. Frank, ain't that grand? A lot of folk coming to take a stand. Mr. Frank, knock on wood. It ain't gonna do you no goddamn good.
I can tell you this as a matter of fact, that the local hotel wouldn't be so packed if a little black girl had gotten attacked.
Go on.
They're coming now, yes sirree. Cause a white man gonna get punk, you see. There's a black man swinging in every tree,
but they don't never pay attention. They'll never say why.
But if a Yankee boy flies, surprise, they're gonna pay attention.
They're gonna yell, set that man free.
Thank you, Mr. Turner.
Welcome, ma'am.
Hey, honey.
You're late?
I know.
I was a little worried. Where were you? I
had a terrible time getting through the parade.
Parade?
Don't you remember? It's Memorial Day again.
Oh, my favorite holiday.
Just think, a whole year?
Seems like 50.
I know. I brought you the official State of Georgia Legislative Law Review Journal, 1907-1908.
Good! Thank you!
I couldn't cook this morning.
What, something the matter with the stove?
No, I was busy.
Doing what?
I had an appointment with that Mr. Craig.
Wait, you were talking to a reporter?
Yes.
I thought we decided you weren't going to do
you
that.
You decided it, Leo. I didn't. Oh. And anyway, Mr. Craig turns out to have a very sympathetic ear.
Oh, God, what did you say?
Well, he asked me how you are, and I said fine. And in fact, very hopeful because you were busy writing up a documented statement that proves all the evidence given against you at the trial was false.
No, you shouldn't have told him that. Now everyone will know.
Were you planning to keep it a secret?
I was planning on releasing it when I'm finished writing it. Don't talk to any more reporters!
I can help you, Leo. All the appeals you and the lawyers have filed have been denied. They are gonna hang you in 6 weeks unless we do everything in our powers to do.
Look, I know you mean well, honey. Really, I do, and I appreciate it, but...
But keep my stupid mouth shut. Of course, Leo. You're right. Like you always are. Do it alone, Leo. Do it all by yourself. You're the only one who matters, after all. Do it alone, Leo. Why should it bother me? I'm just good for standing in the shadows and staring at the walls, Leo. Fight them strong and proud. Pray your voice is loud. Loud enough to make it through.
Lucille, why are you doing this?
No, do it alone, Leo. Now, there's the right idea. Make me feel as useless as you always have. Do it alone, Leo. What could a woman do? After all, so many people love you. They're dancing in the streets, Leo. Only you know how to change the future. But you. I could be a quiet little girl and cook your little meal and swallow all I feel and bow to your command, or I could start to scream across the whole damn South and never shut my mouth until they understand. But I can't do it alone, Leo. Look at me now, Leo. I can be more. I can bring you home, Leo. We can bring you home, Leo. I want you to come
think that's pretty music those fellas sure can play. This song was really made for dancing. Yes, ma'am, that's pretty music. I could dance the night away. Don't you hear that song so sweet and true? But truth to tell, not half as sweet as you. Don't you think that's pretty music? Look now, you're doing fine. Oh yes, you like it when we're dancing. Can't you hear that pretty music? Just keep your hands in mine. Play on, relax, you can't go wrong. I knew you had it in you all along. Thank you so much. You know I'm sure you
afternoon, Mr. Dorsey. I'm Tom Watson.
Oh, of course. How are you?
I support your policies 100%.
Well, I appreciate that, sir.
I hope you've read my piece extolling your virtues. Oh. And Hugh Dorsey was not fooled by the slippery Jew's oily demeanor. No, no. He took one look at Leo Frank's bulging satyr eyes and protruding sensual lips and nailed him for the pervert sodomite that he is.
Well, that is mighty interesting.
And next week I'm writing one entitled, Jesus Was Not a Jew. Well, I'll mail it to you.
Please do. Now, you'll have to excuse me. I must be going.
Well, I don't think you understand, sir.
Understand?
Well, you are the savior of the Southland. And we are gonna make you governor of Georgia now.
Mr. Watson, Georgia already has a governor.
Don't you think that's pretty music? This song sure makes you smile. Shame you don't visit here more often. Take a breath, that's pretty music. Just listen for a while. If your feet don't follow your commands, just put yourself in Governor Slayton's hands. Y'all give her a round of applause. That my, that's quite an introduction if I do say. Look out, too high, got best to hold tight or you'll fly away. I like a girl who's bold, just keep it all controlled. Good Lord, I'm getting old, just dancing with you to that pretty music today. Oh my goodness.
Miss Sally, this is a lovely party.
Oh, I'm so glad you're enjoying it.
Hey, Governor, you're a regular dancing fool.
Yeah, well, that's not the term I picked.
My apologies, ma'am.
I see you chatting up your buddy Tom Watson, Huey.
Well, he's not my friend. Hey, you're the one invited him here, Jack.
A lot of mail coming in about the Frank case. People aren't so happy.
I get it, too. Jews letting off steam.
It's not just Jews. Aldermen, mayors, Governor of Maine, Governor of Illinois, Governor of Oregon, Thomas Edison, Henry Ford.
Yankees, Jewish money in back of them.
I doubt if Jewish money is in back of Henry Ford.
Ma'am, may I have another dance?
No, sir. You may not.
That's it. That's right. I found myself a partner and ain't she sweet? That's it. That's right. A beautiful lady to keep the beat. My steps and yours agree. What more could heaven be? My dear, I guarantee when you're dancing with me, all the world's at your feet. So don't you stop that pretty music. Sure makes me feel alive. If I could dance with you today, we'll show these other folks the way. Those girls are fine, it's true, but I'm the lucky guy cause I can dance with you. So turn that ankle, let that music play.
You are the most wonderful dancer. Hello?
Hello.
Do we know each other, ma'am?
No.
How'd you do? My name is Jack Slayton.
My name is Lucille Frank.
Well, hey, Miss Frank. Or is it Mrs.? Oh, no, it couldn't possibly be. You're far too young to be married.
It is Mrs. Mrs. Frank. Mrs. Leo Frank. I have to talk to you, Governor.
I see. Well, as you can see, Miss Sally and I are entertaining guests just now.
I have to talk to you.
I understand how difficult this must be for you, Miss Frank.
You.
And I surely do wish that it lay within my power to relieve you of
well,
some of your
does.
Anguish. I beg your pardon?
It does lie within your power. You're the governor.
Well, listen to that. Certainly you don't plan on letting the perfectly good one-step go by the wayside.
I didn't come in to dance, sir.
I know, but the music is just so
but
wonderful.
No!
So...
No more dancing! You have to reopen the case.
You'll have to excuse me now. Roy, Helen, how are the plans for that hospital wing coming?
Real good, thanks to you.
And everybody in Valdosta says hey.
Well,
you're
I'm
a smart man. You're trained as a lawyer.
Miss Frank, please. I'm glad to hear that. And you know Valdosta's always been
but
like
don't
a
you have at
me.
Least one small question about the way my husband's trial was conducted?
Your husband was tried and convicted by a jury of his peers. Ma'am, now that is good enough for me.
Then you are either a fool or a coward.
Nibble. They was biting good yesterday.
Are you saying it's me, Judge?
Well, it sure as shit ain't me, Huey.
Well, it could just be a slow day for trout.
Jack Slayton's been calling. Got a bug up his ass about Leo Frank.
Is that why you called me out here?
If he opens this all up again.
Well, who's gonna stop him?
Sun on your back. Neck turning pink, world moving slow, so you know what you think. Nothing but lines and a bait hook to treble the water.
Well, maybe I could pay Jack a visit.
Change isn't bad, change should go slow. One change above could shift 10 things below. Know when to stop, or you find yourself chopping down old trees that still grow. Old ways we all know. The old times, the old days, the glory. These old old times, the glory.
You know what the boys down at the Capital City Club been talking about?
Afraid the Capital City Club's a little out of my league, Judge.
They talking about who to back in their race for governor.
I see.
Just talk so far. But how this Frank business plays itself out.
And if Jack Slayton runs true to form.
When you step into a nest of hornets, someone's gonna get stung. Better to let nature take its course. When you're standing there on top a ladder, hanging on the top rung, you will never feel the river force. But the people down below, since the turning of the tide, they want someone in command who's uniquely qualified to defend them, protect them, restore their respect and their pride.
Counter the slack, temper the speed.
Follow the current and watch where it leads.
Catch what they're missing and learn how to listen to old souls that still cry. Old blood that won't dry.
Old fight, old score. New chance to fight for the glory.
Hello. Yes, ma'am, evening. Oh, no. ma'am, you know that I'm not allowed to do that. Well, all right. Evening. Leo!
What is it? What's the matter?
Message from your wife.
Oh, God, what's happened?
She wants you to know that
You know who is going to re-examine you know what?
Say that again.
You know who is going to re-examine you know what?
Do you know who you know who is?
Can't say I do.
Then you don't know what you know what is.
No.
Oh, my sweet Lucille, how did you ever manage it? You don't know what any of this means. It means cancel all your parties. Forget your big parade.
Now settle down, Leo.
It means the crowds will not be cheering, so despite what you've been hearing, you can lay down your spade.
Usher!
It means my mother can stop crying. My rabbi's eulogy can wait. That Dorsey can stop beaming and my cousin can stop dreaming of his portion of my estate.
Past midnight.
It means no, this isn't over. No, the date's not set. No, I won't wake up tomorrow drowning in my sweat. It means I've got the greatest partner any man can get. It means I'll never, ever, ever underestimate that woman, cause this is not over yet. Tell my uncle not to worry, tell the reaper not to hurry, make the hangman stop his drumming, cause I'm coming into town to win the day. Somehow I haven't with my scheming screwed things up beyond redeeming, and we're finally on our way. And no, this isn't over. Hell, it's just begun. Hail the resurrection of the South's least favorite son. It means I took a vow for better, and two is better than one. It means the journey ahead might get shorter. I might reach the end of my rope, but suddenly loud as a mortar, there is hope. Finally,
yes, Leo,
and no, this isn't
no,
over.
This isn't
no, we are through.
We are finally on our
no,
way.
No, there's still a million things that you and I can do.
I will speak
and
for
I
you,
I would
Leo.
Never have believed it. The things I see in you. It means a man who isn't guilty doesn't have to walk the plank. It means the gallows still are vacant, and we've got my wife to thank. It means you shouldn't underestimate Lucille and Leo Frank. Cause this is not over yet.
You see,
yes, I see.
Even though I did what I
yes,
promised,
dear,
it's
wonderful.
Just what I said
listen,
to you.
Now listen, Lucille.
Yes, I'm listening.
Tell him to talk to those factory girls.
Make
sure he gets the truth.
Make sure he gets the truth.
Call my name. I turn my head. He got no words to say. His eyes get big. My face gets red. And I want to run away. I feel his breath back of my neck. His hand.
Just a minute. Just a minute now. You're saying Mr. Frank made you feel uncomfortable?
Yes, sir. All the time.
All the time? What does that mean?
When, for instance?
I'll tell you. One morning, back before Christmas, me and Mary was in the ladies' changing room and he came right in.
Without knocking?
Yes.
There's no door to the ladies' changing room. Just a curtain. Go see for yourself.
Is that right, Iola?
I reckon. It's true, I swear. Lonnie Mann is sweet on Montaigne.
Is somebody in there?
Yes, sir, me and Iola.
Your break was over 10 minutes ago.
Iola took sick.
Well, she looks all right to me.
I'm a little better now.
Get back to work, please. Mr. Montag does not pay you to dawdle away the day. Please.
Did he ever touch you?
Not exactly.
Then he didn't touch you.
Did he ever touch any of you? the truth. I see. Now you all testified that Mr. Frank invited you up to his office. Who'd that happen to?
Well, Hattie Hoover said that Cynthia Wilson told her that.
Did Cynthia Wilson go up to his office?
Yes, sir.
Well, then why didn't she testify?
She wouldn't.
Why not?
She said it never happened. And Mr. Dorsey said it didn't matter anyway, as long as we...
As long as you what?
All told the same thing, the truth.
But you just said the truth was that he never asked any of you up to his office. Did Mr. Dorsey coach you on what to say? You need anything else from these young ladies, Miss Frank?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Leo, it's just like you
Darling,
said.
Darling, it's wonderful.
Leo, I still can't believe.
Yes, and I know it, but listen.
Leo, where do
both
we
have
get
to hurry.
I am hurrying.
The governor will not be in
I wasn't
office
born
forever.
Yesterday.
Find out why many told all those lies.
Many told
Make sure
all those, Leo, I still
truth.
Can't believe it.
I know, hurry.
I know, make sure she gets the truth. I done told the truth. Mr. Frank, he said go get his shoes. So I go in the bedroom yonder, and I see a pillow and sheets on the floor, just like I said in the courthouse.
That's not all you said, Minnie.
I ain't said nothing but the God's honest truth.
You're not gonna get in any more trouble, Minnie. Just tell us what happened.
The men take me down to the jailhouse, and then Mr. Dorsey keep asking me over and over. He writes something down, and he tell me to sign it. And what else was I supposed to do, Miss Lucy?
Thank you, Minnie.
I'm sorry I done it, but what else was I supposed to do?
No, this isn't
no,
over.
This isn't over.
Not while I have you.
It's exactly what I
While
heard.
There's a million things that you and I can do.
I can't make a decision this important just because you want me to. I need more.
Well, I'm going with you.
No, ma'am, you most certainly are not.
I insist.
This is no place to take a lady. Not even you. But I will try not to behave like a fool or a coward.
Yeah.
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 I hear thunder. It's behind that wall.
Yeah.
We're gonna roll like thunder. I'm gonna taste the morning. Feel the rain fall.
Feel the rain fall.
Sunshine. When I see a tan, I'm gonna rise like sunshine. I'm gonna sit down on earth, feel the sun burn.
A visitor, boy.
Female?
You wish.
You know it.
Hello, Jim.
You who I think you are?
I guess so.
All right, then.
Couple questions for you.
You want some water? Bring the governor some water.
No, thank you.
We finna talk about that mess with Mr. Frank.
Yes.
I'm already doing the years in the century. What more y'all want?
Just a little of your time.
What are you girls looking at?
Yeah. Well, I got a little something to say. I made a little mistake up there in that witness stand.
Is that right?
I said I found that dead little white girl with her head towards Alabama Street and her feet towards Hunter Street. Well, I was wrong. She was laying the other way around.
And that workroom, that's the one on the second floor.
Everything else is just like I said in the courthouse.
Well, then I'm a little confused.
Why is that?
Well, when they found the body in the basement, coroner's report says there was sawdust in the mouth and lungs. You got any idea what that means?
Yeah.
Means she had to be breathing in the basement, because there's no sawdust on the second floor. Means she had to be alive when you carried her down into the basement.
Well, then she must have come back to life because she was dead as last Christmas Eve when Mr. Frank showed me the body. We're gonna roll like thunder.
Coroner's report raises some questions about your story, wouldn't you say?
That coroner, he the one that's blind?
That's right.
There's plenty of lint on that second floor. Might not have been sawdust in that little girl's mouth. Could have been lint. How'd he know the difference? I guess lint and sawdust feel the same to a blind man.
Well, he's got 45 years of experience.
That's so. Then you can prove that in court, I imagine. You ever been on the chain gang, Governor?
Not yet.
You ever broke those rocks on the chain gang? Get yourself thinking, Governor, how you wanna have a good time,
I'm through with him.
Now, Mr. Frank, he had a good time. Man knows how to have a good time.
Ready, Governor?
As I'll ever be.
Then let's go.
Turns out you married a jackass, Miss Sally.
Well, is that supposed to be news to me?
All those fine plans. Congressman and Mrs. Slayton. Maybe President and Mrs. Slayton. I'm fixing to lose us all that.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'd a whole lot rather be married to a fine ex-governor than first lady to a chicken.
Is that so?
Yes, it is.
Well, then you're as big a jackass as I am.
We really better go.
Yes, ma'am.
I have an announcement to make. Leo Frank is no longer a prisoner at the Fulton Tower. At 5:00 this morning, he was removed to another prison location, which will not be disclosed at this time. 2,000 years ago, another governor washed his hands and turned
with your head held high, or move aside when they're passing
you
by.
I have reviewed all the evidence in the case.
Will you run?
Now I have decided
when the fires are fanned. And where will you stand when the flood comes?
Georgia will hold judgment until they have given calm and careful consideration to the statement I have made on the case.
Will you ride by the side of God, or will you hide in the soil and the sod? Will you fight for the soul of your land? Well, where will you stand when the flood comes? Where will you stand when the flood comes? Care to comment, Mr. Dorsey?
I was not a part of the governor's decision, Mr. Watson. I'm as surprised as you are.
Will you beg for the Jews' reward, or walk with us at the side of the Lord? Put your soul in the devil's hand. Well, where will you stand when the flood comes?
Where will you stand? Where will you stand? Where will you stand?
With you, Mr. Watson, I'll be proud to stand with you!
God bless the next governor of Georgia!
Yes, I see through the fog and dust, so let the mob do whatever they must. Slayton jumps at the Jews' command.
Well, where will you stand when the flood comes? Where will you stand? Where will you stand? See the stain at the Jews' feet. Traitors won't keep the mobs at bay.
Mary, Mary, the angel child.
Mary, Mary, the angel child.
Still your name and your soul are defiled.
Still your name and your soul are defiled.
Thank God you can't.
Thank
the
God you can't
to
the things they say.
Well, someone's gonna pay.
Someone's gonna pay. Someone's gonna pay.
Lucille, hey.
Hey. Hey, Mr. Peavy. I know I'm a little early, but it felt silly to sit down there at the train station and twiddle my thumbs.
That's all right, I reckon. Don't you think so, Leo?
I reckon. You're one... Look, you... Is that a new outfit?
Yes.
It's very becoming.
Thank you, kind sir.
Well, this is a new one on me. Warden ain't allowed nothing like this on this prison farm since I've been here. That's 24 years.
You don't say.
Wish my wife would do something like this for me.
Your wife gets to eat with you every day.
Yeah.
This will be the first meal Leo and I have shared in over 2 years.
Hmm. Oh, sorry.
You're a wonder, Lucy.
Am I?
You know you are.
What's that?
Oh, it's nothing.
That's not nothing.
Well, I had a little accident.
Well, what, is that why they wouldn't let me visit the last 2 weeks?
Yes, ma'am. Had him in the infirmary.
Well, what happened?
That crazy fool Billy Crean come at him in the shower with a razor blade.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, T90 bit deeper, they said. That nurse said he'd have been a goner for sure.
Leo!
It's fine. I'm almost completely healed. Now, how did you get the warden to let us do this?
I got his daughter a job in Atlanta, clerking at Jacob's drugstore.
Did you bribe him, too?
Not yet. Oh, my, Mr. Peavy.
Yes, ma'am.
Could you do me a favor? My neighbor lady insisted on sticking this in the lunch basket. Neither Mr. Frank nor I care for it. Could you think of anyone who might have...
Yeah, I suppose I might.
Oh, well, thank you so much.
I'm glad I could be of help, ma'am.
Lucille, what is all this?
Just a little picnic out in the country.
The country?
Of course. Isn't this the softest patch of grass you ever saw? And see those flowers all down the meadow? I wonder what they are.
I think they're called black-eyed Susans.
Black-eyed Susans, of course.
This is our wedding china.
Well, naturally. This is a momentous occasion.
Yes. Yes, it is.
I've never seen you with a suntan.
Well, I am a farm boy now. Probably the only Jewish farm boy in the South.
It's very becoming.
Thank you.
You can plant us a vegetable garden when you come home.
Okay.
You are coming home, Leo. It's only a matter of time now.
Well,
No! It's going to happen. As soon as all the fuss dies down, you'll be pardoned completely. I'm sure of it.
I will never understand what I did to deserve you, or how to be the man that I'm supposed to be. I will never understand, if I lived a thousand lifetimes, why you did the things you did for me. Just look at you, how could I not be in love with you? What kind of fool would have taken you for granted for so long? All the wasted time, all the million hours pushing you away, building up my walls, all the days gone by, to glare, to pout, to push you out, and I never knew anything at all. At all.
I will never understand how all the world misjudged you, when I have always known how lucky I must be. I will never understand how I kept from waiting there till you came home. Now look at me, now that you're finally here. Now that I know I was right to wait, and everyone else was so
at home.
I'll be right out, Mr. Peavy.
So, how do we bribe the warden to let us do this again?
We won't have to, silly. You'll be home.
I love you.
I love you too. See you Sunday.
See you Sunday.
What is it?
Yo, coming with us, Mr. Frank.
What? What? Wait, let me put on my pants!
You don't need no pants where you're going. We brought you here! Mr. Frank!
Answer me.
I understand.
Good. Get locked, let's hurry.
We are fixing to carry out the law rendered upon you by the state of Georgia. Do you have anything to say?
What I've always said, I am innocent.
And that's a damn lie!
Way easy there. It's almost over. Come
here. Just a moment!
Jesus, time's wasting. We gotta go.
What is it, Mr. Frank?
I'm not wearing any. I have on no. When you put me up there, I'll be exposed. Please. Can I be covered?
Get that croaker sack yonder.
I sure wish we didn't have to do this. Maybe if he just confesses, you know, we could take him on back to the prison.
No!
We are carrying out the law!
That's what I'm saying! Maybe if he'd have confessed in court and... Oh, shit. Maybe if he'd have confessed in court and said he was sorry, you know, I believe he would have got himself a life sentence. Now, I believe that he would have...
A bunch of pansies!
Listen, we can drive you back down to that farm. It looked like a nice place, and you can live out your days. You just gotta admit it. Say you're sorry.
I am sorry.
You see? Do you see?
It's a tragedy that lovely little girl had to die.
And you wish you hadn't done it, don't you?
I'm afraid I've had to give up wishing.
Just tell us, sir. That's all we ask.
All right. I will. I believe that God has a plan in all this, and I believe that he chose me for a reason. So all this time, I have considered, and I've pondered, and I've prayed. But for the life of me, I can't seem to come up with what that reason is. I do know this, though. I did not go through the last 2 years to stand here and tell you a bald-faced lie. That is not a part of God's plan for me.
He didn't do it.
Shut up.
Mr. Frank, for the last time, did you kill Mary Frank?
I did not.
Let's get this over.
Make sure it's tight. We don't want him to suffer anymore than he has to.
Wait!
What is it, Mr. Frank?
I want my wedding ring to go to my wife.
Anything else, Mr. Frank?
Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kavod Malkuso Leolam Vayel.
Thank you.
Hello, Miss Frank.
The story's over, Mr. Craig.
I know. I'm back covering the police beat.
Why have you come?
Here. Fella came by the office. Wouldn't tell me his name. Said to give this to you. I heard you moving back north.
No, I'm not leaving home.
After all this, and now with Dorsey being elected governor, I guess folks just figured you'd had about enough.
I am a Georgia girl.
Well, I'm always sorry, will ma'am. Be. I'm
sorry, ma'am.
Sorry. Hey.
Yes?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm sorry for your loss.
I came for my pay.
Name?
Mary Fagan.
You'd better hurry.
Why?
It's Memorial Day. Don't you have a parade to cover?
Employee number?
507.
$1.20. Here you are.
Leo. Oh, Leo. I know he'll protect you. And don't be afraid. I'll be fine here, you'll see.
$1.20. Here you are.
These hills that remind